is excited about space and science. And, you know, we really couldn't have it for a better day.
Thank you.
that might not put a piece in. Back on the surface of the So or so are just in this grant. So I'm wondering if you can help me get questions. I think we'll just have a
and being power to the Professor Rick at the University of Maryland, who is the author of the book, and he technology. combining multiple suppliers.
Submarines that have been operating for decades, they often have power levels of certain effective power. Thank you. So, even if you have to do this work today, that we can help us to get the
Allen from the University of Central Missouri. I have two questions. One, I believe you worked on the EM drive. Or familiar with it, and I don't see any updates on that. Last time, we just kind of some people were getting results from the EM drive. And anybody currently working on nuclear detonation, that will kind of like the old Orion program in the 60s.
I thank you for the question. In terms of
incredible talk. I'm Audrey Stock from the University of Chicago. SEDS Stock is well, I obviously have a lot of questions, but I'm going to limit myself because you have a lot of admirers, I think, in the world. But I think that mainly what I want to ask about is what are some other aspects that you can think of that antimatter rockets making use of matter, antimatter annihilation. Negative vacuum space. So I was just wondering on that front, and also what this is a good return investment for this technology. Of international investment required to make this aspect of interstellar travel feasible.
So, to your first question
My name is Cyrus Fessel. I'm from Arizona College Prep High School. And I was wondering, would you be able to send out the negative vacuum energy,
It's okay. Would you be able to send it up
and just measure how much acceleration it produces?
That's an interesting question, right? I like to
My name is Ari Gottesman, and I'm from the University of Michigan. So this particular interstellar travel has been about 100 years at the fusion house. It's been done on how we'd actually have humans live on a rocket in the United States for 100 years.
Well, that's a great question. Other than power propulsion, what are some other important things?
Arizona College for the first time in high school. And I was wondering if there was any plans for a lot of students around the college.
might have Bison's Spear or Bison's Moon. Have you ever heard of it? Do you think it's feasible that within a couple of centuries that we could have technology such as that?
In any near term for outsourced on Earth, do you have any account for in-house input for the power output? Do you think that it's likely that may see more sources in-house systems, such as in V-pinch devices, over actual realistic power on Earth?
So let me go back to good question. This is a good one to end on. So, in my mind, retail market is a good one. Thank you.